The search for independence started early for Fatima Anwar. The 23-year-old lives with spinal muscular atrophy. She fled Afghanistan with her parents and three sisters. One of them also lives with the same condition.
The house that we were living in, there was only one bedroom that was really accessible for myself and my sister. And you could imagine a bedroom tiny.
The business master's student was determined to move out of the family home. Using specialist disability accommodation funding in her NDIS plan, Fatima now lives in an accessible apartment in Sydney's west.
Alexa, lower living blinds.
It features wide doorways, Alexa, voice recognition technology, reinforced concrete for a wheelchair hoist, and she chooses her own support workers. Brisbane sisters Sam and Jamie Lee Dwyer have Frederick's ataxia. They've just moved into a similar style of housing after years in accommodation they describe as a nursing home.
We weren't allowed to choose what support workers helped us.
They say living in the community has improved their quality of life.
We can finally do what we want to do and feel like we're involved in the community.
Apartment complexes like this are slowly popping up across the country. They also have a concierge with an on-call support worker to assist residents when their own carers clock off.
Advocates have cautiously welcomed the approach.
We are a bit worried that these congregate settings, these large clusters of units and houses, are potentially reverting back to more institutionalised settings.
For Fatima Anwar, the move has been life-changing.
I get to learn a lot more about myself and everything else that I want.
Naz Campanella, ABC News.